हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द क्लास. बेटा, इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी रेड दैट व्हाट इज कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, व्हाई डू वी नीड कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, एंड वी आल्सो रेड अबाउट आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली, व्हाट आर द बेसिक फीचर्स ऑफ आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन. देन वी रेड अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्टरी डॉक्यूमेंट ऑफ आवर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, दैट इज कॉल्ड प्रीएम्बल, राइट. नाउ टुडेज टॉपिक इज द इंस्टीट्यूशनल डिजाइन. नाउ व्हाट डू वी मीन बाय इंस्टीट्यूशनल डिजाइन बेटा? Like whatever the basic principles, the guidelines, the philosophy and values, those are given in our constitution. Now how to implement those guidelines? So all these things come under institutional design. So today we will read the topic institutional design, that how the government will run the country and how the government will how the constitution will put limit on the government and how the various organs will work. So let us start the topic. Design. Constitution is not merely a statement of values and philosophy. It is about embodying these values into institutional arrangement. It means whatever basic principle, philosophy or values, those are written in our constitution, how it will be arranged in various institutions. Constitution of India is about these arrangements. It is very long and detailed document. It needs to be amended regularly to keep it updated, because as we know that there are dynamic changes in the country, so according to those changes we are to amend our constitution. So constitution has to be in accordance with people's aspiration and changes in society. That is why it is amendable. It is not seen as a sacred, static and unalterable law. So provisions are made to incorporate changes from time to time, which are called constitutional amendments. The constitution describes the institutional arrangements in a very legal language. The Indian constitution lays down a procedure for choosing persons to govern the country. Like which procedure will be followed to choose the persons who will govern the country. It means how the member of parliament will be elected, how the elections will be held. All these things are written in our constitution and the procedure is given. It defines who will have how much power to take which decision. As you know, in our constitution, there are three lists are given. Like first one is the union list. It means which departments or which subjects will be solely handled by the central government. That comes under the union list. And the second is the concurrent list. Means whatever subjects or decision that will be taken by the central government as well as the state government, those comes under concurrent list. And the third one is state list. There are few agendas that are solely handled by the state government, those comes under state list. It means that is division of power between state and central government. So the constitution puts limits to what the government can do. It provides some rights to the citizens that cannot be violated. Means our fundamental rights, it cannot be violated. And even our all fundamental rights, these are protected by the fundamental right of the key points. First one is, who was the chairman of the drafting committee? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. That is why he is known as the father of our constitution. Then, who was the president of Constituent Assembly? Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Then, when was the first constitution for India was prepared? It was prepared in 1928 by Motilal Nehru. Then, Nehru's famous speech on August 15, 1947, what is it called? It is called Tryst with Destiny. And, what is the name of autobiography of Nelson Mandela? A Long Walk to Freedom. As he spent 28 years in jail. for this freedom. That is why he the name of his autobiography is A Long Walk to Freedom. So this was about this chapter, the constitutional design. So now we are aware about the how the democratic constitution of South Africa was framed, same way how the constitution of India was framed, and what is the working of our constituent assembly. And now we also know the basic principles that are given in our preamble. So this was all about this chapter. Thank you and have a nice day.